Okay, so we are back now here. So we're looking for the Red Skull Key, and behold, out of all the places in the entire map, it was right in front of us the whole fucking time. Can you believe that shit, man? So I was telling Nexus, yo man, are you looking for the Red Key? He's like, yeah. So I tell him, yo man, turn around, it's right behind you. She's like, what? No, man. How the fuck can that shit be there the whole time? I mean, that is so easily... like mist. You can like just pass by in like the heat of action and combat. You can't even see that shit. Like it can blend in with this color of the sky a little bit, especially when you got enemies left, right, and you're just running around really fast. You can miss it really easily. So that just wasted a lot of our time. Wow. So finally we actually got the Red Skull Key and we did make it outside. Luckily, I had already killed a bunch of enemies out there, so there was less work for us. But man, that sucks. That really sucks, you know? Like, you spend all that time looking for this fucking key, and then you can't find it. You think, like, in the most difficult places, like, looking in secret walls or pushing buttons, checking every single room, double-checking every single fucking room again, and then, in the end, it's right at the top of the hill. Right there. Like, ah, fuck, man. That sucks. That really sucks, you know? Just finding the red key just sitting there, right there on the ledge, and you didn't even know. I mean, in most cases, it would be, like, on a pillar on the ground, but that time, it was, like, on a ledge of some sort, and we just missed it so easily. I couldn't believe it. I was like, fuck, wow. It was right in front of us the whole fucking time. So, yeah, that sucks. That really sucks. So, like I said, we did manage to get outside, and there's really not that many enemies. There's actually two paths here in the acid pool here. There's one to the left and one to the right. I tried to get there, but then I was like, oh, fuck, I got killed. That sucks. I mean, there's a shotgunner there, and he blasted me, like, pretty much instantly, you know? Instantly, man. So, yeah, in order to get through that door, yeah, I think you got to get the yellow key, I think. Yeah, the yellow key. So he got the red key, that's all we need, so now we can just go back to the door and make our way to the exit. I think I told him to check the right side and see if there was anything there. I don't remember if he checked it out and if he told me there was anything there or not. I don't know. But anyways, I took the left side and this was where the previous Hell Knight was, the very first one. See the body right there? So I come around here, I'm like, oh shit, there's another one inside. So inside there is actually the exit. You can try your luck to kind of push him out of there. I was trying to, but the button wasn't like registering when I push it. See, I'm right in front of it. So I'm guessing I gotta kill him first before I'm allowed to push the button. So it's not too difficult. I'll make sure it works with the Hell Knight anyways. I mean, even in a small room like this, as long as you keep running and strafing in one direction, he's not gonna hit you really. But it's good to keep your distance anyways. So, I don't know where Nexus took off to. Not really sure. But, you know, whatever. That's the end of that level in episode 4. So now, finally, we move on to the next level. In episode mission 4 of the Doom co-op playthrough. So, this is what, Unto the Cruel or something? I don't know, man. You know, some of the names of some of these maps are like, really weird. Like, the stuff like Warehouse, Military Base, that's pretty standard, you know, but Unto the Cruel and Death's Awakening and shit like that, man. Shit like that is just really fucked up. Really weird names for that shit. This level, there's actually two doors in the pillar right in the very center there. Because I'm going to the right and he's going to the left, and the very center actually has the wall that requires the red key on the right side of the middle area. And this side just passed actually has the yellow one. Each one has a giant meatball in it, well, the Kiko Demon. You're pretty much the fucking meatball, man. The fucking meatball. Fucking meatball, man. If I remember correctly, I don't think this level was really that long or hard. The layout and the design of the map and the placement of the keys, if I recall correctly, it really wasn't that difficult. Not like the last shithole that we were into and the one before that. The one before that, wow, with that damn cyber demon that was like blocking our exit. That sucked. That level sucked, man. That really sucked, really. So right here, I was wondering if I can run and pick up one of the items. But it's kind of risky. I'd rather just take the free armor and keep going forward, I'd say. I couldn't really tell if the platform at the bottom could have been like fake blue water that would damage you or something. You never know. Because I think in two of the levels, there were like these blue circular lights that were in the ceiling and in the bottom of the floors. And I thought they were just like lights until you walk over them and then you actually lose life. So down here, I'm getting cornered by the fucking Hell Knight. I'm trying to get out and the Nexus gets in my fucking way, man. I'm like, dude, get the fuck out. There's no room. There's no fucking room for two of us in here. Fuck. So I took some heavy damage. Yeah. I took it for the team, man. I fucking took it for the team. But it wasn't so bad. At least I get to replenish my shotgun ammo with these dudes right there. So, I was like, yeah, man, I deserve that fucking mega sphere. I want instant fucking health. So, I deserve it, man. I want that thing back. So, we got the yellow key now. So, we can actually open the left side of the center pillar, which I'm actually right beside. Just gotta take down those pinky demons first. So, in there we got the red key already, you see. So we just gotta open those two sides, and I believe there's a button inside of them, but there's a giant meatball blocking them, so we just gotta kill them. Yeah, there's a meatball in there, there's a meatball in there as well. You don't really want to stay on the center area because there's not much room to kind of dodge their shots. And it's like really risky because if you stay in the center, you can actually fall off into the lava pit right there. And I don't know if there is an escape or another place you can get out if you fall inside. So right here there's another fucking meatball as well. So I don't know if I picked up the plasma rifle. I don't think so. Did we get the other button? On that, you know, oh, there we go. Yeah, the platform is raising. Yeah, this level really wasn't that long. It really wasn't that long. It wasn't so bad. So this is the end battle right here. You actually see that green platform to my left and right. I didn't even notice this, but at the top, there's a mega sphere on the left and the right mega armor. So, like I said, this is the last very last boss battle. So we're fighting basically another spider demon as we did in the previous episode. So anyways, we don't actually see the power-ups on these green pillars until like after the battle. Because we were so like into the moment, like, holy shit, there's two fucking Hell Knights, a spider demon, there's like no room to dodge. Go up, go up, go up. So it was getting kind of hectic there. It was hectic. Then we got giant fucking meatballs too, man. Got a fucking brain of fucking spider legs anyways. After this match, there's really nothing else. This is a final boss battle. So we're working on just killing the little minions first, because the spider demon doesn't really pose much of a threat. Mainly if you have some cover in front of you and it. Look at this. We basically use the giant pillar right here to our advantage, the big brown one right there. So you can go in, take shots, then take cover, and then repeat. It'll almost never get you. I think because it needs some time to start shooting its chain gun, like it has to look at your direction for a little bit before it starts to shoot. Maybe that's the case, but it really wasn't that hard, really. So I told him, you know what, there's a plasma rifle in the left corridor. Just go up the stairs, it's all clear. So it's good. You know what, share the weapons with your friends because you can set the options to keep the weapons spawned in the map so they can pick it up too. So we're just picking up the boss right here. He's up there, you know, trying to distract him from behind and on top, and I'm picking him off, you know, from the bottom here. It's really not a hard boss, you know. It's really not. I was expecting another type of boss that I've seen a very long time ago, but I think it's in Doom 2. I think so. So you see spider boss there, the spider demon is dead. The second one we had to kill, fuck. The second one, man. So when this platform actually lowered, I was thinking, oh shit, we got another part to go. So I was like, okay, let's get the power-ups, and then we'll go in. So, I was asking him how much health and armor he had, and he had less than me. I mean, yeah, he had more than me, sorry. I was the one who had less, so that's why I picked it up. So I told him I would go first, And what do you know? It's actually the very end. I was thinking there was going to be more down there, but, you know, that's good. We finally got through the co-op playthrough of the original Doom game. It was fun. It was fun, man. We had some fucking bullshit moments, but, you know, we got through it. It was good. So, thanks for Nexus for playing with me. It was fun, dude. And in the future, I hope I can get to do a co-op playthrough with some of my friends on Doom 2 as well. So stick around for that, guys. And this is pretty much the ending text. And that's about it, man. So all I gotta say is episode 4, that one fucking level. That spider, the fucking cyber demon, it was really fucked up, man. That was fucked up.